You got a stiffer man ready to go, right?
Are you going to do it?
Welcome everybody to a behind-the-scenes look at the Mr. Creepypasta panel.
Stiffer man already did that. They filled in all the blanks with this.
Quite a crowd we got.
Just filling all the other blanks with moisture.
Get
that furry shit out of here.
Get that furry shit out of here.
Environment. Children and families. And butt stuff.
You want me to go?
Now we have to switch to right. Is that easier this month? Okay. Who's ready to be creepy?
So, wow.
Then you're in the wrong
place. That is very moist. So mean.
Damn it, Junior.
Wrong kind of creepy.
I love symmetry. I'm not sure exactly why, but I've loved it ever since I was a kid. Most children are messy and predictable of their things, but not me. Oh no. I knew everything had its place. And in my room, everything was right where it belonged. My parents didn't have it. My grandparents didn't have it either. Not a single person in my family had it. I've started referring to it as it because I truly believe it's something inside of me. A stowaway that shouldn't be there but lives in my core. It's a need. A desire. A longing to be perfect. Perfect on both sides. As an adult, I'm at the point where I can't live my life normally. I can't keep a job. Women don't stay with me long because they just can't handle it. Honestly, I don't even care when they leave. They're messy and they just make things so difficult. They roll over to my side of the bed instead of staying on their own. They leave dishes in one side of the sink, but not the other. I can't work anymore, so when they leave for the day, I have to stay home and fix everything. It's a relief when they leave for good, though. But that feeling never lasts. Eventually, it comes back and finds something else that needs fixing. You may be asking, why? Oh, why would I seek out relationships to begin with if I just can't stand them? Well, it's hard for me to sleep in the middle of the bed all night without moving. Other than the relationship problems, my life is pretty much in order. I say pretty much because there is one last issue that must be dealt with. You see, I have what's called heterochromia iridium, or two different color irises. My right eye, a cornflower blue. My left eye, a pale green. Both my parents have cornflower blue eyes, my siblings and cousins as well. My green eye is the broken one. It makes me unbalanced. Every time I look at myself in the mirror, it stares right back at me. It's all I ever think about now. Everything is in its right place except for my green little mistake. It didn't hurt at first when I dug a spoon under my eye. It didn't even hurt when it popped out and was just hanging by my cheek. Was it shock that was keeping the pain away, or was it? I sniffed the optic nerve and blotted the warm fluids that were streaming down my face. Oh, my vision being cut in half was a strange sensation. What was left of the dangling flesh, I placed now in the empty socket. I bandaged the wound, rinsed the spoon, and went to sleep. I woke up happy. I slept better than I had in years. It was finally done. I was fixed. I got out of bed and stumbled to the bathroom. Oh, my body ached and my head was on fire. I flipped the switch in the bathroom and the light was blinding. Slowly, I removed the bandage that was soaked with blood and was sticking to my face like tape. When I looked up to the mirror, my stomach turned. Only then had I realized what I had done to myself. I couldn't believe it. There was a hole in the left side of my face, but not the right. I was unbalanced. Again. It was much harder digging out the second eye. My hands were shaky, and when I dug the spoon in, I missed several times, puncturing my pupil 3 times before I got into the right place. Once the eye popped out, I reached for my scissors to finish the job. The blood from the previous night had dried the blaze, so the scissors, they just didn't cut very well. You know when you're a kid in elementary school and your teacher made you cut construction paper for art projects? Did you ever try to cut too many pieces at once? But the scissors just couldn't take it. The blades would kind of fold over each other and the paper would get pinned between them. That's what happened to my eye. The optic nerve was pinned between the two blades. It was stuck, and as I tried desperately and frantically to make it unstuck, I slipped on the blood and started falling to the floor. My reflexes kicked in, and I let go of my eye to try to break my ball with my hand. Oh my God, the weight of stuck scissors on my hanging eye was unbearable. I knew I couldn't stand long enough to make it to the kitchen to get a knife, so I pulled. I pulled it straight out of my head. I felt the flesh tear from inside my skull. I felt it rip and spew liquids everywhere. I knew I was crying, but there was no telling the tears from the blood from the ocular fluid. When I heard the wet flash, the wet slap of bloody flesh against the tile floor, I knew I was done. I knew it was done. I could live my life normally now without having to see people's awful, messy, uneven lives. The relief washed over me, and somehow I knew it would last this time. I had never felt this way before. Never had this much hope. As I lay in my bathroom on that cold, wet, sticky tile, I smiled for the first time in years. The end.
Hot damn, son. Hot damn.